to allow me to heat the AMI up before I get in it in the morning. I fitted this 250 watt desktop fan heater. It runs off the mains. When I'm in the garage, I just plug it into the mains outlet. But I've also connected it up to an inverter run by a 50 amp hour 12 volt battery. That's it in the battery box behind the seat. And the inverter's behind the other passenger seat. Printed up a little box to mount the remote switch for the inverter. Just Velcroed it to the window at the side of the car. And it shows the state of the battery. And you can switch the inverter on and off. It's a very gentle waft of warm air that comes out of the heater, but it's enough to defrost the windscreens, and you can put it down by your feet, and it heat up under your feet, keeps you nice and warm. I had a couple of trips out to either go for a walk in the countryside or take my folding bicycle out. This is in a village of Dollar. Just pulling up to a Chargeplace Scotland charging point. I've now got a tough leads, Type 2 extension lead, so I can now reach most of the charge points if there's other cars in the road. Luckily this time the Jaguar I-Pace parked on the other side of the car left me enough room to get in. Just fiddling about with the lead here. That's it plugged in.
Yes. It's working now. Yes, you've got to switch the two switches on in sequence. Right, and we are showing we've got 56 minutes to charge up.
So we're coming back after the walk. And the lights are off on the dashboard, so it must have fully charged.
It's going to take 1.148 kilowatt-hours.
Jaguar had been on there for a long time, still wasn't fully charged.
1.148 kilowatt hours, 1 hour and 9 minutes.
And switch off plugs A and B, or B and A in fact, in that one.
I'm just going to plug.
And then unplug. Yeah.
So, plug A now available, the green light.
Another day, I've come out with my folding electric bicycle this time. Same charger, but unfortunately it was one of the charge points was being used and the other one was broken. There was a red light showing. So I'm going into the app for Chargeplace Scotland.
What's that?
Looking for
Scotland.
Another charge point close by. Nearest one was about 4 miles down the road in Tillicoutry. Luckily, Tillicoutry is on the same cycle path as I was going to go down. So me just pulling into the square in Tillicoutry, where the singular charge point is. No other cars there today. I came here one time before, but couldn't get close enough to the charge point because cars were parked in the road. now with the extension lead I have, I would have been able to reach it. The tough leads extension cable, you can see there, you just plug the AMI's little 2-pin socket plug into the socket, and then at the other end you have the AMI's Type2 adapter that then plugs into the charge station. That's me getting my folding electric bike out. Fits reasonably neatly into the footwell. And there I'm off on my 15-mile cycle ride. That's me coming back into Tillicoultry. Must have been an old station here. This was an old railway line that ran right along the hill foots. There's a little AMI still sitting there, all by itself. Present your card again and then switch off buttons B then A, then you can extract the cable. Fold up, roll up the cable, try not to get tangles in it. I've also got the tough leads case for holding the cable, which is handy for just throwing behind the seat. This time I'm going a wee bit further afield, crossing the River Forth to go to Falkirk Stadium, which is near the Kelpies, which is a little park with some nice sculptures in it, and then cycle down the Forth and Clyde Canal towpath down to the Falkirk Wheel. And back again. Ships no longer go up beyond this point, so the swing bridge has been permanently closed, and they have built the Clackmannanshire bridge where this traffic in front of me is coming from, further upstream, that wouldn't allow large vessels to pass under either. So I'm going into a short stretch of national speed limit dual carriageway. It's only about half a mile before the turn off. And here we come to Falkirk Stadium, a football stadium. And then you can see on the left hand side there's a covered car park and a big charging station with lots of charge points. I think it has something like 13 Type 2 charge stations. And also other chargers, fast chargers in there, as well as these simple Type 2 chargers. Yes, there are a lot of chargers, just really need to pick one and park there. Of course, I parked on the B side of the charge station that I picked, and then when I presented my card, it says plug into the A side. So if somebody else was coming along, they would have to put the cable on the opposite side from where they were parked as well.
Right. Halo dash cam active. We've got 25 miles range remaining, 472 miles covered.
In my little Fidu D2S folding electric bike.
Halo dash cam active. Only showing 31 cut off. 31.
Yeah, there must have been 72. Some problem with the charge station, because it only charged for 27 minutes. It gave me 6 miles extra range.